morrow, chaps. What is up, everybody? Welcome back to some Micro Machines. I love what I did with today's episode because I learned something very important. I should never, ever, 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 ever try to build rockets. Because the rocket I tried to build went through about 18 different iterations in the span of 30 minutes. So, yeah, I'm not the best when it comes to building rockets, apparently. Weight distribution ratios and stuff are not really my forte. So I really failed with today's build. However, I did successfully build a rocket. So, yay, congratulations to me. I did successfully build a rocket. However, the rocket you do see right here is so terrible, I had to redesign it twice. I'm pretty sure that it went through two massive redesigns. However, I do like how unstable these rockets were. Now, the thruster I had on the bottom of this rocket that you can see right here has got very good gimbaling, and I thought that'd be enough to, you know, compensate for the fact that the Kerbal itself knocks the rocket a little bit off tilt and, you know, sends it out of control, which was kind of strange. However, there is one thing I did not know, and that is if your Kerbal is not wearing a helmet, they die. Yeah, I did not know that. So yeah, we lost a Kerbal on the first time. However, with a quick reset and of course the attaching of a helmet, we can try again. And I'm pretty sure I only do half throttle on this because I was like, let's see how it goes. Now, this is a three-stage rocket, so you've got your main stage, then you've got your second stage, and then right at the top is your tiny little third stage. It's one engine, three fuel cells, and a nose cone, as well as the seat, as you can see right here. But seriously, this rocket is just so uncontrollable. I had to put fins on it to try and stabilize it. I thought, you know what? Let's think properly. Let's think like, you know, arrows, rockets in real life have fins. Let's put some fins on it. Because this is basically an intercontinental ballistic missile. I can never say that word. It's basically a missile, this. It's not really a rocket. So I thought, fins, stabilization, let's do this. No, it didn't work at all. Like, I tried, you know, throttling back. I tried manually trying to control it. But no, this thing was just, I don't know. It was either top heavy or the Kerbal was just enough to knock it off kilter a little bit. I don't know. I was very terrible. This first rocket design was pretty sure the worst rocket design I've ever built in my life, and I've had rockets that go backwards. So I decided to go smaller, and this rocket might look familiar. This is a similar design to the one that is in my intro, and I thought, you know what, it worked for the intro, but it didn't have a Kerbal on it. Let's see if I can stick a Kerbal on it. I did tweak it a little bit as well, and as you can see, it's pretty stable. And while I was doing this, something came to mind, which was, basically, I'm launching a space shuttle. Now, I know I'm not launching a space shuttle, but when a space shuttle goes up, because there's a lot of weight on one side, it does a roll so it can stabilize as it goes up. So I thought, you know what, that'd be a really good idea. Let's actually try and do the same thing. However, as you can see, it's not really working out. In fact, it's not even coming close to working out. This rocket designs, when they are big for me, work. Rocket designs, when they are tiny, don't work. I have no idea why. I could spend the time to do the math, because contrary to belief, this game is not just click and build. There is a lot of math in this game, which is funny because I suck at maths. But it kind of works out right now. So I've managed to stabilize the rocket, as you can see, a little bit. I'm no longer going down. And the best part of the entire rocket, the most stable thing in creation, was this part of the rocket right here. This part of the rocket got me up to, I think it was just under 19,000 feet. I should have just launched this from the beginning. This probably would have done a lot better than the rest of the entire rocket. And I do want you guys to help me on this. Now, I'm not a rocket scientist, obviously. So I want to know what was going wrong. Am I right in saying that the Kerbal was, you know, putting the, you know, shifting the center of mass off a little bit, and it was just, you know, in the wrong way? Or if you guys know, because some of you guys have helped me out with my previous builds, there was a guy who commented to move the wheels back on the wings of my previous micro machine, which did actually increase the stability. So thank you very much for that. So is it the Kerbal that's knocking this thing off kilter? Because I'm pretty sure it's the Kerbal knocking this thing off kilter. However, something interesting did happen when I was, you know, coming to the end of this thing. I'm not doing this, by the way. So I'm trying to roll it to keep it stable, and it did that. This weird kind of pitching and then pitching back. It was kind of weird, but as you can see, yeah. Maximum, just under, it was about 18,000 and a half, I believe. But look at that. That is a cute little rocket. I wonder if I could actually just... I wonder if I could use that to get into space. Probably not. It's a funny little rocket, though. I mean, that is the most stable thing I've ever built that goes straight up that is tiny. I mean, I'm pretty sure I have a Saturn V, like a one-to-one recreation of a Saturn V that works perfectly, which I did for one of my Apollo missions previously. So maybe I'll have to build a miniature version of that and actually get to the moon at some point, which would be, I don't know, impossible. But I just thought I'd leave this. This was the most relaxing part of the entire thing for me, just watching this Kerbal spin back to Kerbin. It was absolutely beautiful. So I'm going to leave you with him free-falling for a little bit. But anyway, as with every landing that is not assisted by a vehicle, a parachute. I'm so glad they put the parachute in the game. It saved this Kerbal's life. And pretty damn smooth landing. I mean, you know, it slid for quite some time, which was, I don't know, maybe they oil these guys up before we send them into space. But we managed to get him back down to the ground. So I'm calling this one a successful flight. We got close to space, but we didn't get in space. However, we did land, technically. I mean, the rocket didn't, but we did. So, you know, yes, here is the spot in which our hero safely returned to the surface of Kerbin unharmed. I think that is a very fitting plaque for today's little thing. But that is it, ladies and gentlemen. If you've enjoyed today's episode of Micro Machines, please go ahead and like, share, and subscribe, because we're getting close to 300, which is quite impressive. But apart from that, you know the drill. Like, share, and subscribe. And until the next episode of Micro Machines and the next episode in general, stay awesome.